Sport and the athletes making a splash at the World University Games. In Gwangju in South Korea, there were medals to be won in 21 sports altogether. We'll take a look back at the team sports later and the top nations at this massive Summer Universiade in South Korea.
It's a big competition, 11,000 people from all around the world. You can have a lot of fun.
It's a really nice place. You get to meet new people from different countries. You get to learn different languages.
Everyone seems really excited to be here, represent their universities, their countries.
It's really awesome to be in such a place. I mean, like in our country, we don't participate in such a competitions.
It's a truly once-in-a-lifetime experience.
I'm enjoying it.
Viva Universiade!
The 28th Summer Universiade kicked off for a 12-day festival of university sport with a spectacular opening ceremony. 7,374 athletes were here and more than 3,300 officials, representing 137 countries. And over 40,000 staff and volunteers would be on hand in support. Gwangju, situated in the South Jeolla province, is known as the City of Light, and it showed it during a colorful show, a show designed to unite young people and promote global peace and harmony. The central message, youth is the true light of the future. Day one, and in the pool, China dominated. Was Zheng Shuangshui diving to victory from the 1 meter springboard. She'd repeat her gold medal performance from Kazan, edging out the Korean diver Nami Kim. And in the men's 3 meter springboard, Peng Jianfeng dominated to lock down China's second gold. Altogether, China won 8 events out of the 11. In the men's synchronized 3 meter springboard, though, two brothers, Evgeny and Vyacheslav Novoselov, snatched the gold on the last dive, beating Yuming Zong and Yanan Li, Korea taking the bronze. The Russian brothers, relieved after their performance. After our last dive, I didn't want to look at the results straight away, but when I saw that we were first, I couldn't believe it. It was a dream come true, a victory at the Universiade. I'm so happy. The Canadians Caroline Ware and Selena Jane Toth had only a few days to train before the synchronized 10-meter platform event. Selena, a psychology student competing in synchronized diving for the first time, but they took it a dive at a time, and their confidence grew.
With the little amount of practice that we've had, we basically just put whatever we could into it, and going up in the boards today, we just wanted to do our individual dives well, but put them down together, and I think that for the first time, we did a good job of that.
We were more focused on our performance. Yeah. Like, we weren't watching what was going on. We were just like, okay, we need to do this, and we did it, and that's how we dove.
That's how we got this.
Yeah.
Ranked third after the first round of five, the Canadians rattled off three fantastic dives to move comfortably into first place. South Korea would come second. And Han Wang and Ying Wang of China rounded out the podium with the bronze. The Canadians very pleased with themselves.
They are pretty dominant, but I think we're catching up. And yeah, like Caroline said, we didn't focus on them, and that was never, we didn't expect to win, and we you know, weren't expecting to beat them, I don't think, but they weren't our focus. Our focus was us.
The last time that Canada had won a medal in diving at the University Games was way back in 1999 in Mallorca. The most successful athlete at Gwangju was the American swimmer Shannon Vreeland, with 4 gold medals and 1 bronze. In 2012, she got Olympic gold in the 4x200 meters freestyle relay. And here at the World University Games, she was unbeatable over the 100 and 200 freestyle. She certainly came prepared. Here's her team coach, Ray Luza.
We have very, very difficult competition as they, from the young ages all the way up to this point. So they have to really fight for their positions. So this team or the Olympic team or world championships, very difficult to make these national teams. So by virtue of having to be in that pressure pot situation all the time, when they get to a competition like this, they're prepared, comfortable.
Vreeland got gold and silver at her first World University Games in 2011. And here in Guangzhou, she did her bit in the relays again, as the USA took gold in the 4x100 and the 4x200. Altogether in swimming, the Americans grabbed 14 gold medals, partly the result of that impressive university system of theirs.
Well, USA Swimming really believes in the NCAA system, and that's what governs our university system athletically. And from the age 18 to 22, they can study, you know, move on with life in that regard and get world-class training at the same time, as opposed to only swimming or only studying. And this is the unique part of what the United States has. And, you know, it just allows us to, you know, have, you know, kids that, you know, are here at a high level.
Joshua Pronneau, a member of the American team, demonstrated his strength with 2 gold medals. In the 200 meters individual medley, Pronneau shared top spot with the defending Australian champion Justin James in a dramatic dead heat. And at the 200 meters breaststroke, he beat Japan's Kazuki Koenata to the line. Joshua, very much a product of the American system.
We have a very strong university system. Myself and all the coaches on deck coach at universities all over the country. So we are bringing our athletes and athletes from all over the country to compete here.
Like the women, the men were unbeatable in the 4x100 and 4x200 relays. Altogether, they set a new games record in the swimming competitions, a total of 41 medals, with the World University Games seen as an important stepping stone on the way to the Olympics.
We have a lot of young, inexperienced swimmers that are fighting for a spot on the Olympic team. We normally bring in about 5 swimmers from here into our Olympic team next year. So they're all getting experience and having a lot of fun.
But there were winners from other countries. The Brazilian, Henrique Martins, has won world relay titles, and he was a silver medalist at the 2011 Universiade in the 4x100 freestyle relay. This time, he got a gold in the 100 meters freestyle, 400ths of a second ahead of one of the Americans, John Conger, Marga Bellotti of Italy, claiming the bronze.
Oh, it's great. last time I've been in the University Games, I was watching the races and I say, one day I want to be in the first place. And 5 years later, I had the chance and I got it, you know, so I'm feeling pretty good right now.
3 days earlier, he'd shot to third place in the world rankings as he powered through the 50-meter butterfly race, a time of 23.22, winning the gold medal in front of the Belarusian Yavhen Turkin and Piero Codia of Italy. He also took silver in the 50 meters freestyle. Clearly he's in good shape, 1 year before the home Olympics in Rio.
Saw a news last week, 48% of the Olympic medalists had a medal here in University Games. I think that shows how strong this competition is.
Henrique Martins, an outstanding Universiade champion. Could he be a champion at the upcoming Olympic Games as well? We'll see in 12 months' time. A gold medal match in men's water polo between Italy and Hungary. In the fourth period, just 1 minute before the end of the match, Hungary were leading 7-6. But Italy's number 12, Giacomo Lanzoni, equalized to force a penalty shootout. So the Italians hopeful, but Tamás Seidl-Meyer finally settled it in Hungary's favor. for a final score of 14-13. In the bronze medal match, the USA beat Serbia 5-4. In the women's final, Canada were against Australia, the Canadians leading 3-2, but then Australia sneaking a goal under the arm of the Canadian keeper, Nicola Coulter-John. Just 2.5 minutes to go at that point. Another penalty shootout then. Elodie Ruffin getting the goal that sealed it in the end for the Australians. Incidentally, the silver medal is Canada's first in women's water polo. Bronze going to Russia after they beat Italy. On to the rowing, 285 kilometers from Guangzhou, the venue here of the 2013 World Rowing Championships. And Lina Saltytė adding a fourth gold medal for Lithuania, the top rowing nation at the Universiade. The sports coaching student from Kaunas simply too strong for the rest, and beating Ukraine's Natalia Dovgodko by 3.7 seconds. The Dutch rower Marlies Oldenburg in third place. Germany, normally a strong rowing nation, won just one gold medal in the men's coxless fours. The Netherlands took silver in this one, beaten by 3/4 of a second. Italy got the bronze. Coming up, Fabian Hambuchen, the Olympic silver medalist on the horizontal bar, goes for gold at the Universiade. And we'll have shooting and archery at our sights as campus sport continues.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values: excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Artistic gymnastics at the Summer Universiade, and this, Fabian Hambuchen, the sport management and communication student from the Sport University in Cologne, now wrapping up his university career with a gold medal on the horizontal bar.
I cannot find the words to describe it. I mean, the last 2 months have been so rough for me, up and down so much, so I'm really, really, really happy about this medal now. And it's been my last Universiade, so I'm kind of sad because I will definitely miss that atmosphere here, and just happy about that medal, and it was a great day.
The competitor declared as FISU's best male athlete would score 15.266. Finishing behind him, the two Japanese, Nonomura and Komoto. Right before the Universiade, Hambuchen had won a gold and a silver at the European Games of Baku in Azerbaijan. And there's no doubt the German gymnast is in good shape.
It was a good routine, not my best one, but I came through it. That was much important. I had the highest difficulty of all gymnasts. So at least I'm, as I said, I'm really happy, but it was really, really close and the other guys have been so strong.
So gold for the man who was the Olympic bronze medalist in Beijing and silver medalist at the London Olympics. Now to the floor, finishing fifth here, the winner, Hayasaka Naoto from Japan. Hambuchen, by the way, recovering from an injury to his little finger and only decided to compete here a few weeks before the start.
It's like 2 months ago, maybe, pretty late. It wasn't planned this year. We have different events like World Championships in October, but I loved it in Kazan, so I didn't want to miss it, you know, so that's why I'm here again, and it was just a pleasure, a lot of fun.
At Kazan, he'd been on the podium as well, winning 2 silver medals. But he won't have another chance now. The maximum age limit of the University Games is 28, and Fabian is approaching his birthday. But he enjoyed his final appearance in Guangzhou, and it allowed him to complete some unfinished business.
I was dreaming 2 years ago about this medal, and then I had a mistake on high bar, so I was really sad about that, and I definitely wanted to get this gold medal today, but it wasn't easy. It was a hard fight.
Job done. Fabian Hambuchen can now open another chapter in his sports career. Oleg Verniaev, Ukraine's European Games champion, now going for a Universiad title in the individual all-around competition. Having won gold in the all-around and the vault just 2 weeks ago in Baku, Verniaev began as favorite, and he lived up to his billing with a superb display. The 21-year-old is a consistent performer in all six phases. His best perhaps coming in the parallel bars, an event in which he won the world title in 2014. He would take the gold ahead of Shogo Nunemura of Japan and America's Akash Modi, who grabbed the bronze. The Ukrainian score, 92.075. The women's all-around gold was won by Britain's Kelly Sim. The four disciplines, the floor, the vault, uneven bars, and the beam, and Sim, a student of applied sports science at Southampton Solent University, taking second place in the vault, the third on the floor, and a points total of 56.332, with Japan's Asuka Teramoto and Natsumi Sasada completing the podium places. The 21-year-old Korean Son Yeon-jae was the second-best athlete of the Games. In rhythmic gymnastics, she won the all-around final ahead of the Ukrainian Gianna Ritsat-Dinova and Melitina Staniata of Belarus. Son ranked first in all four disciplines, the hoop, the ribbon, the clubs, and the ball. She got another two gold medals in the individual events with the hoop and the ball, and she didn't expect all these victories at all. She'd been injured, and that had delayed her training for the Games. After that, she took silver with the ribbon. The ribbon winner, by the way, Melitina Staniata from Belarus. Ritsat-Dinova in third place. And there'll be another silver medal for the South Korean gymnast. Son, this time with the clubs. Starting to let her guard slip a little bit, perhaps. It's one of her two specialities, along with the hoop. But she dropped one of the clubs towards the end of the routine, and that would mean she'd share the silver with Melitina Staniata. Staniata, who was seriously injured with a fractured leg back in 2010 and needed several months to recover, now delighted to be back on the global stage. Gianna Ritsat-Dinova was Son's most dangerous rival in the Games. In 2013, the physical education student from Kiev was the world champion with a hoop. Now, in Guangzhou, she took the gold medal with the clubs and a score of 18.2. For the first time, handball was included in the sports of the Universiads, and the first women's final saw South Korea against Russia. And the Koreans, who have a good reputation in the senior game, fought with plenty of support, pushing the Russians all the way. They got as close as 38-36, and the Russians had to hustle, but they hung on to become the first ever winners of the World University Games. South Korea, the silver medalists. Portugal beat Serbia in the men's final. Portugal leading in the second half by 20-13, but Serbia kept on pushing and put them under a lot of pressure. Into the final minutes, and even though Serbia came close, Portugal ultimately were just too strong. The final score, 25-21, silver for Serbia, Switzerland taking the bronze. And so to the sport of badminton, and the host country were the tops in front of the local crowd. Six events, six gold medals. Overall, the South Koreans had a fabulous Universiad. First in the rankings with a total of 108 medals, 47 golds, 32 silver, 29 bronze. Russia actually got more medals, 122 altogether, but fewer golds than the South Koreans. China will go home with 72 medals. Now to shooting, and Silvana Stanko was bang on target. In the women's team trap, she helped Italy take the gold with a Universiad record of 202. Then the student of the Piedmont University added another gold in the individual competition, beating her teammate Frederica Caposuccio. Australia's Catherine Skinner took the bronze. The Italians were unbeatable in the trap because when the men stepped forward, Valerio Grazzani, an economics student, was top shot. Defeating Philip Marinov of Slovakia 14-12, Yavuz Ilnam from Turkey shot his way to the bronze. The most successful nation in archery was South Korea, 8 gold medals in 10 events. But in the final of the women's team compound competition, the USA faced Russia, the Russians proving too accurate in the end, winning by 220 to 218. And Chinese Taipei won the women's recurve team event. Still to come on Campus Sport, we turn to basketball. Volleyball too, as we concentrate on the team sports at the University Games. And we'll round out the Universiad with the football.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Finals. The women of the United States met Canada in the basketball final. They'd survived a tough semi against Japan, only booking their final ticket in double overtime. Now they would beat the Canadians to take their 6th title in a row and the 10th in Universiad history. So what's the secret of American dominance?
I think anytime USA plays basketball, you know, the expectations are to win. And so there's some pressure also, but it, you know, we have, you know, we have a great USA basketball system in the United States. Players grow up playing, and you know, I think that's really helped us.
USA, you know, usually we're known for winning a lot of gold medals in basketball, and just to come here and continue the legacy that previous teams have, you know, been successful at. It's just a great feeling to play with these group of girls for almost a month, and to come here and work hard and win the gold.
The first quarter was closely disputed. Team USA finally taking the lead. 2 points from Mercedes Russell, making it 13-11. And then in the second quarter, Ariel Powers applying more pressure on Canada with her 3 points. And by the end of the second, the USA had stretched their lead to 31-23. In the third, Canada's number 6, Carissa Williams, helping her team claw back. Despite some smart and spirited play, Canada still trailing though at the end of the third, the score 48-45, but getting closer.
I think we came out with a lot of energy in the third, tried to bring it back, and then they just went on a long run and we weren't able to stop them.
Yes, indeed, Team USA going into the fourth quarter just with that slender lead, but really upping their game in the final minutes. Sydney Weezer pumping the score up to 82. Dakota White of Canada getting 2 points back in the dying seconds, but the final score, 82-63, USA.
It was tied up. We weren't working as a team enough, and then we had the coaches getting on our butts, and we just kind of, you know, if we want to win, we got to win together and stop playing selfish. So basically, that's what helped.
So the Americans won the World University Games once again, and they'll undoubtedly be the favorites for the next Universiad in Chinese Taipei in 2017. The silver, Canada's best ever result, bronze to Russia. The American men beat Germany in the final, earning the USA its first World University Games gold in men's basketball since 2005.
Just keep competing. I mean, we didn't give up. We didn't give up on ourselves, and that was key. We kept fighting.
Germany, though, could have won the game themselves and were very disappointed afterwards.
It'll take a little bit for the pain to wear off, but, you know, with time, I'll look back, and this will be a great 10-day experience. I love the guys, love the coaches. Just how tough we couldn't win at the end.
In the final moments of regulation time, Mason had converted two free throws for the USA, tying the score at 66 apiece, ruining the Germans' first chance to win. And then in the final seconds of the first overtime, with the United States again trailing by two, Mason tied the game once more, forcing another extra period.
Yeah, it was a tough game. I mean, we fought so hard. We wanted that gold medal so bad, but at the end, they hit some tough shots. So, yeah, it was just a tough game.
Now Germany were trailing by one as Mattis Möhninghoff nailed 3 points to give them the lead once again in this seesaw battle. 77-75. That, though, was their last score as the USA stormed at them, first retaking the lead one last time, then pushing on and putting themselves out of reach. Wayne Seldon getting the last point for the USA. Game over. Seldon clutching the basketball, flinging it into the air. The USA were the winners.
It's one of the greatest feelings ever. I mean, this is probably the biggest stage I've ever played on. I'm just so excited. I'm happy for everyone that came here. I'm happy for everyone that was supporting us. I'm just happy for America. You know, we're getting, being able to take this home. You know, I'm just ecstatic.
The Jayhawks from Kansas City were the first basketball team from one college to represent the United States at the Games since Northern Iowa in 2007. 2 years ago, the USA finished only ninth, featuring a collection of college standouts. But now, the Jayhawks have put them back in the limelight. Women's volleyball in Ukraine, trying to forget their defeat with a selfie, beaten to the goal by Russia. The Russians celebrating. They were simply too strong. First set went to them 25-12, the second set 25-17. The third period was tighter, but the Russians took it again 25-17, running out the winners just as they had in Kazan 2 years earlier. The bronze going to Japan, who beat Brazil 3-1. So the Russian women, very happy. So too were the Russian men. The men here facing Ukraine in a tough, tight final. Ukraine lost the first set 25-27 and the second 23-25, but they started to dominate in the third. That set going to the Ukraine, 25-21. In the last period, though, Russia biting back. The defending champions winning the fourth set, 25-17, and taking the final by 3-1. The bronze to Argentina this time. Chinese Taipei going down to them, 3-1. There were rainy, difficult weather conditions for the women's football final between France and Russia. No score in the first half, but in the 67th minute, Valérie Gauvin getting the first goal for France. Mm-hmm. 82nd minute, a corner. The Russian defender, Lyubov Kiepatkova, scoring an own goal. France, 2-2. And that's the way it stayed. Final score 2-0. France, the Universiade champions. Russia taking the silver. Japan, the bronze. South Korea were trying to win their first Universiade gold in men's soccer since 1991. But they never really threatened the Italians. In the 11th minute, Tommaso Biasci getting goal number one. The South Koreans went a man down after just 6 minutes. Dongjin Park sent off. 32 minutes gone, Paolo Reggioli with the shot to make it 2 for Italy. And the last to get on the score sheet, Leonardo Morosini. Final score, Italy 3, South Korea 0. And so, Italy became the Universiade champions, South Korea not quite able to go all the way in front of their home crowd. Japan took the bronze, they defeated Brazil in a penalty shootout. So So those some of the top performances from the World University Games. And next month, we'll have more action and stories from the Summer Universiade of Gwangju with a focus on athletics. Plus, the games are seen by one of the 12 students on the FISU Reporter Program. A word too with FISU's Universiade Director, Mark van den Plas. All that and more in the August edition of Campus Sport.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values: excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.